to celebrate the goodness of the Lord in our lives. Praise God. Amen. And personally, would like to welcome every one of you who are here today. And of course, our beloved speaker, Reverend and Mrs. Agbayani, amen, for honoring our invitation for them to come and minister to us. Amen. And also for our ministers who are here with us. Amen. Praise the Lord, brother and sister. Pastor Thunder, amen, is with us here. Brother and sister Soto, a pastor from the Philippines. Amen. And also our minister, Brother Hall. Amen. And Sister Hall, praise the Lord. And our dear sister, Pastora, Ortiz, yeah. Because sometimes Bayuna, sometimes Ortiz, before San Martin. Praise God. I know the name is written in the book of life. Amen. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Praise the Lord. And of course, the family of Sister Dolores. Amen. Birthday celebrant. What about birthday celebrants for the month of May? 86. Yeah, but actually, yeah, just thankful, amen, for Sister Dolores. Her life is a testimony. And yeah, can you imagine the children, grandchildren are here? Amen. To honor her, thank you so much. We welcome you in the name of the Lord. And I don't know if we have some other ministers who are here today, but I really thank you and all of you visitors. And we have the reason to go forward. We are now in these last days, and we need to go forward, amen, looking upon Jesus. That's very important, because we are now in this closing time, and it's shaking time, and we need to be strong in the Lord. Okay, going forward with the right doctrine, believing that there's only one God. Here Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. That's what I'm always saying, that we need some Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego who will stand, amen, for the truth, amen, and we're so thankful for that. And we will go forward with a mission, winning more souls for the glory of God. That is our mission, to go forward and win souls, right? Amen. And then, of course, we need to have we will go forward with a mission and a vision.
Right.
Yes. Oh, hallelujah. With a vision.
Yes.
Praise God. And we are so thankful for the vision that the Lord has given us. Winning souls. Be an encouragement, a blessing to your community. And be a blessing to your church. And of course, looking forward for the future.
Right.
Because Jesus is coming soon.
Yeah.
Hallelujah! Amen. And He's coming for His church, for His bride. So we need to go forward. Because a lot of hindrances, just like the children of Israel, our elder Chavez has read to us what happened. They are facing the Red Sea, and the enemy is pursuing them. And no way out. They cannot go to the right. The rocky mountain of Baal Zephon. And also on the left, the wilderness, and so dangerous. And then no way out. But then when they prayed, when the man of God prayed, what shall we do? The people were not crying. And God said, tell my people to go forward.
Amen.
Go forward. Don't stop. Praise God. So today, amen. I really welcome every one of you, and I just want to share to you a little thought here as a message to the church. I want to share with the story of a Chinese bamboo tree. Have you heard about the story of a Chinese bamboo tree? Not yet? Okay, good. Because if you know it, I will not read it anymore. Since you don't know, we just know probably the the bamboo tree in the Philippines. Okay. But here, one of the most unique and amazing plants in the world is the Chinese bamboo tree. This tree is much different than most trees in that it doesn't grow in the typical fashion. Once planted, one must water, feed, and nurture the seed every day. It must be placed in an area of sunlight to receive nutrients from the sun. This process continues for four agonizing long years. For 4 years, there is no evidence of growth. For 4 years, there is no evidence of life. For 4 years, it seems like no one is totally wasting their efforts. But then, in the fifth year, an amazing thing happens. The tree finally breaks the surface of the ground. And in the space of 5 weeks, only 5 weeks, grows of an astounding height of 90 feet. It is as if the tree grows right before a person's eyes. When I read of this amazing wonder of life, I can't help but think of the time and effort we invest in our ministries, often without any evidence of growth or life. There have been many times I have personally invested my time, talent, and finances into a person or ministry without evidence that it would pay off. There have been times, because of this, that I have given up on a person. Yet, there have also been times after giving up that I have seen a breakthrough and that person I work with finally accepts a Bible study. They finally come to church. They receive the Holy Ghost. Those years of hard work and effort finally pay off. Okay? In the Bible, in Galatians chapter 6, verse 7, the Bible said, "Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, he shall also reap. For he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap everlasting. And let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not." I have come to learn that God's growing season is much like a Chinese bamboo tree. There isn't anything typical about it. There is no rhyme or reason to it. We will never understand how God operates. We just need to understand. In due season, we shall reap. If we faint not. I sometimes wonder if God placed the Chinese bamboo tree on earth for us to learn from. What most people do not understand about the Chinese bamboo tree is that the growth is not all occurring during 5 weeks span in fifth year, but underneath the ground, the seed has actually sprouted within days of being planted. During those first 4 years, this bamboo tree is actually growing very strong, deep and extensive root system below the surface of the ground. This extensive root system is necessary to sustain the life of this amazing tree. One cannot see the growth with the naked eye, but one who understands plants know exactly what is happening.
They cannot see it, but they know the seed is growing. They keep feeding, watering, providing sunlight to it because they understand if they stop, this plant will die. This is a great big picture of faith. That's why it happened in our ministry, even in our family. Praise the Lord. I have a lot of men and women in the church that I pastor that sometimes people will say, oh, no future. Those guys, no future. They don't have any interest. But then the Lord has teach us to be patient and pray for them. And continue to pray and care for them. And one day, miracles to play. That's why I really love the song that says, He's still working on me. God is still working on me. This church, we're not here to judge. We are here to be an encouragement. For those parents, even your children sometimes will just say, oh, mama, I don't have time. I'm too busy. But just keep on watering. Just love them. Share your smile to them. But one day, you will be surprised. Because the Lord has given us an example. Learn from the bamboo tree. Amen. Can you imagine for 4 long years, no sign of life. But when 5 years comes, just 5 weeks, it will grow tremendously. And you are that bamboo tree. Look at what the Lord has done in your life. Praise the Lord. That's our church. Hallelujah. Those of us who truly understand God know that He is going to do what He promised He would do. Do you believe that? Amen. He will fulfill it. He will do it. Our faith in God is what keeps us going. Amen. We continue to invest our time and energy into the kingdom because we understand that something is happening just beneath the surface. Whatever is happening beneath the surface is a necessary part of the answer. We may not see the answer today, but that doesn't mean that the answer is not being worked on today. Our faith in God gives us the patience to keep working and waiting until the answer does come. Even in James 1:3, the Bible said, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. In going forward, we need to be patient. Patient to one another. Be patient in serving God. And in Hebrews chapter 6, verse 12, that ye be not slothful, but what?
Followers.
But followers of them, but through faith and patience inherit the promises.
Amen.
Faith and patience. It's not religion, friend. But it's our faith. That's why we are thankful to the Lord that the Lord has given us a lesson today about the bamboo tree. And I hope this 8th church anniversary, praise God, will remind us. If discouragement and hindrances will come your way, just remember the bamboo tree. Lord, thank God for giving me the roots.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. And we're so thankful for the truth that the Lord is blessing us. And we just love the Lord for a moment. Come on. Come on, open your mouth. Jesus. Hallelujah. And by this time, I would like to ask my good friend, Reverend Thunder, to come and also greet you. Amen. Praise the Lord. As you all know.